Many people do a lot to attract wildlife, like bird feeders, backyard ponds, and so on.
But sometimes wildlife ends up inside your home with surprising, maybe even shocking results. News 8's naturalist Jack Hubley takes a look in tonight's wild moment.
As if the world news isn't enough to keep us awake at night, another crisis has recently reared its cold-blooded head, reptiles and amphibians in our toilets. Cindy Letourneau writes, I have a snake problem in my toilet. A big snake came up my toilet and scared me to death. I need some advice. Actually, this is merely the tip of the snake berg at the Letourneau house. Toilet snakes were a recurring problem for Cindy for more than a year, until a friend winched the offending reptile out of the bowl. Turns out it was a black rat snake over 6 feet long and feisty, to quote Cindy. Just imagine lifting the lid and finding something like this looking back at you. If that's not enough to induce constipation, I don't know what is. So how does a Komodo dragon like this gain access to your sewage system? Since this is a bit out of my area of expertise, I called my plumber. He explained that when wildlife breaches sewage security, you should check the cap on your vent pipe. Looks a little like this, kind of like a turtle. Sticks up on a PVC pipe in your yard. If the cap is broken or missing, snakes can easily gain access. This, however, does not explain the mystery of Carol Kaufman's toilet frog. Carol writes, we were cleaning a seldom-used bathroom, and when my husband lifted the top of the toilet tank, a frog was swimming there. We have no idea how he got there. We have no pet frogs here, only cats. Carol, I've got to tell you, this one even stumped my plumber. The only possible access would be at the top of the tank. My plumber tells me that the newer toilets have an indent along the upper rim of the tank that allows air to flow in when the toilet is flushed. But how your frog would have climbed up to that indent is a mystery. So I was going to suggest you name your toilet frog Houdini, until I found out you've come up with an even more appropriate name, John. I'm Jack Hubley, News 8.
Next week, Jack identifies a mystery animal photographed in a Pennsylvania forest. And remember, if you have a wildlife question for Jack, you can email it to news8@wgal.com. And you may see him make bad jokes about it here on the